The text and dollar functions allow you to do something that normally you're trying to do the exact opposite of. So in this case, what you're trying to do is you're actually trying to take a number and make it into text. So normally the problem is that Excel's not seeing the number as a number. But in this case, can you see we've got some salespeople and they've sold some units, and you'll see that looks all nice. However, when we try and convert it into a sentence, so we've used a concatenate and we've said, okay, we want to try and say that this person sold that much. Notice that even though that's got a nice space there, you don't see a space here. And you'll see over here, we're looking at the 40%, which looks nice there, but in reality that number is a massive decimal if you look at it. So what we want to do is somehow control that we don't see this. We see it with what it looks like here. The only way to do that is to convert it into text. So the way you do that is there's a function in Excel called text. All it asks you for is where must it look. So in this case I'm going to say look at the units. And then the format of the text. I'll show you just now where you can find these, but I know that the format I need is hash space hash hash zero. And all you need to know is you need to put inverted commas around it. So again, I'm going to show you a quick way to find these towards the end of the video. But you'll see it's going to take a number 2800. And you can see it's converting it into that same number, but there's inverted commas around it. It's text now. So when I say OK, I can copy it down. And notice over here, this one's now actually seeing the space. Same thing with the percentages. Function to use is the text function. Look at the percentage and the format we're going to use with inverted commas 0.0%. Close it. When I say OK, you'll see it shows it. So here we had 38%, but in reality, there's some other numbers there. We've decided to add another decimal on. And notice now that this sentence just looks a bit neater. Does with sold 40.3% of stock. Just to show you, these codes, you can look them up. What you can do as well is perhaps click on the cell, and when you go to your normal formatting of cells, so you've gone, you've formatted, there's a percentage, to see what Excel, how Excel sees that, if you click on custom, it'll take you straight away to that one. So you'll see here, if over here we typed 0% only, it would have looked exactly like that. For example, if we look at this one and I go to format cells, again, I found what I liked. If I go to custom, I could have actually used this. So in our version, we just used the first part. But if you actually wanted it to also turn red, you could have just gone, copied that and pasted it into the correct place. There's a similar function called dollar. And what that does, it assumes you want to convert to your local currency. So as you can see here, we've got our salespeople, we've got the sales, but when we try and convert it into a word, not only does it not have the currency symbol and no spacing, but because this has got a whole bunch of decimals, we're seeing that. So there is a function called dollar, and all you do is you point at a number and you tell it how many decimals to include, so I'm going to say 2. The assumption is that it will use whatever the currency of your computer is. So it won't use the dollar unless your currency on your computer is dollar. So in our case, it's rand. When I say OK, you'll see it looks like that. And when I copy it, you'll see that now the sentence makes a lot more sense and it's a lot neater.